In this example, we're going to calculate the equilibrium conversion for a gas phase reaction of methanol and water reacting to carbon dioxide and hydrogen. The reaction's at 2 bar, and the water to methanol ratio is 1.5 coming into the reactor. And the question is, what's the equilibrium conversion at 80 degrees C if we assume these are ideal gases? So this means we're going to have to calculate first equilibrium constant, and so it's a multi-step problem. The first step is to calculate the Gibbs free energy change at 25 degrees C for this reaction using the delta G's of formation for each of the components, that we look these up in a table. The second step is to use the delta G of reaction at 25 to determine the equilibrium constant at 25. So I'll call this K1 to represent the value at 25 degrees C. Next, we want to calculate the equilibrium constant at 80 degrees C. So first, we're going to assume that the heat of reaction is independent of temperature. And this is a pretty good approximation because the temperature range is pretty small here. So we're going to calculate the heat of reaction at 25 from the heats of formation at 25 degrees C. And again, these are values we look up in a table. And then we're going to use the Van 't Hoff equation to get the equilibrium constant at 80 degrees C from the equilibrium constant at 25 degrees C and the heat of reaction. And then finally, we're going to use that equilibrium constant, an expression that relates the activities of each of the species raised to their stoichiometric coefficient, the product of the activities, to the equilibrium constant. So what I'll first do is look up the values for delta G's and delta H's of formation for each of the species. So I've listed the values for delta H and delta G, and notice that for hydrogen, delta G and delta H are zero, because remember, when we say heats of formation, we mean what's the energy to form this species from the elements. And since hydrogen's elementary in the standard state, then delta H and delta G of formation are zero for hydrogen. So the first step is to calculate delta G of the reaction at 25 from delta G of CO2. This is all at 25 plus 3 times delta G of hydrogen minus delta G of methanol minus delta G of water. So the stoichiometric coefficients are used where they're negative for reactants and positive for products. And these are all at 25 degrees C. So these are all delta G's of formation. So I'll substitute in the values from the table. So I made the substitution and calculated delta G minus 3.6 kilojoules per mole. I'm now going to use this delta G reaction at 25 degrees C to calculate the equilibrium constant at 25 degrees C. And there's a relationship. The equilibrium constant is the exponential of the change in the Gibbs free energy at 25 over RT, Gibbs free energy change at standard conditions. I'm going to substitute in the numbers and want to be careful with the units. So first thing, important, is a minus sign here. So it's minus delta G over RT. So we have minus 3.6, which I'm going to convert to joules per mole. And then I can use 8.314 joules per mole per Kelvin for the gas constant. And then the temperature is absolute temperature 273 plus 25 to make it Kelvin. And all of this is in the exponential. And when I do that, I get the equilibrium constant 4.28 for the equilibrium constant at 25. And I'm going to call that K1 to make the next calculations a little easier. So as I indicated earlier, in order to get the equilibrium constant at another temperature, I first have to calculate the heat of reaction, and the format is the same as calculating the delta G of reaction at 25 degrees C. I'm going to calculate the heat of reaction at 25 degrees C. So I've written down the heat of reaction at 25 in terms of heat of formation of products minus heat of formation of reactants. And then I've substituted in the values from the table. So I get the heat of reaction 49.2 kilojoules per mole. And this is positive, so it's endothermic. And we're going to assume this is constant over the narrow temperature range. We can then apply the Van 't Hoff equation to relate equilibrium constant at two temperatures. So the Van 't Hoff equation says the natural log equilibrium constant at temperature 2 over the equilibrium constant at temperature 1 is related to the negative of the heat reaction, which we're assuming is constant, over the gas constant, 1 over temperature 2 minus 1 over temperature 1, where these must be absolute temperatures. So I can substitute in the values. So when I've substituted in the values, note that I converted the kilojoules to joules, put in the correct gas constant in units, put in the temperatures. Temperature T2 is 80 degrees C, or 353 Kelvin, and temperature T1 is 25 degrees C, 298 Kelvin. I know K1, that's 4.28, so I can solve this equation for K2. So this is equilibrium constant at 80 degrees C. Remember, equilibrium constant is dimensionless. And then I can substitute in the equilibrium constant in terms of the activities raised to their stoichiometric coefficients. And then in the next screencast, part 2, we'll apply this equation to determine the equilibrium conversion.